BBC Electric team, this is Dr. Sarah Jane Pell, commander of the Lunaris 3 crew on the Spectra mission. I have here with me the amazing team who are just going to briefly introduce themselves.
My name is Alman Samra, Vice Commander.
Jane Hastings, Mission Specialist.
Andrea, Medical Officer.
Simon Parker, Geoscientist.
Mark Flickgerber, Mission Specialist.
And you might recognise this guy from Practive VR in Australia. And we've had the pleasure, we're enormously grateful to have received the Lucy Electric Trident RMU switch. And we have all now experienced both the training with the virtual reality produced by Practin and a hazardous environment training scenario where we went in a power out situation here and had to go out to the lunar crater to switch a fuse and solve the problem. So some of the feedback that we have from the crew has been pretty incredible. We spent all day filming for you yesterday. The crew didn't know that a hazardous environment situation was coming. It was a bit of a surprise for them. So they had the training with the operations manual and the virtual reality. And some of the crew only had the training with the manual. And both teams had to go out and problem solve under time-based pressure. So it was enormously inspiring for us, challenging for us, but the team performed really well under pressure, and suffice to say, we have the power back on. So some of the crew are just going to give you some initial feedback and thanks to share with you some of our experience and gratitude for the opportunity that you've given us.
Hello, Lucy Electric, this is Omar again. We had an amazing experience learning everything. I started from a zero knowledge base of not knowing anything about high voltage equipment or how to fix them or maintain them or anything, to getting the VR training and the theoretical training, and then went out yesterday in the hazardous scenario. And I can say now that having done all of that, I'm fairly comfortable with doing most of it. We had a lot of feedback. I hope that you get a chance to listen to it all. I think the biggest takeaway for me is that the VR training was excellent. Having the VR component as part of that is priceless. And with a few modifications, it can be even better. I especially like the idea of being able to see everything and get the spatial recognition of everything before actually stepping out into the real environment. I thought that it served me well during the emergency situation. And I look forward to seeing the updates and hopefully seeing it in more practice and more prevalent.
Hello, Lucy Electric. I wanted to thank you very much for an extraordinary training environment. While I don't have much experience either with high voltage equipment nor with VR, it was a truly exceptional experience. The environment, the artistry of the environment was just amazing. So to begin with, it was an engaging environment to enter into and to feel comfortable. Simulated quite well the experience of having limited vision, limited movement, thought the flow was quite effective of the environment, having the ability to pull the menus so you can refresh yourself of what the next step was. I would say maybe going forward, allowing the user to turn off some of the prompts so that they can test their knowledge in new scenarios, giving them a wider range maybe of scenarios of different issues that they might encounter in an emergency situation or even in maintenance would be my
I definitely agree with Omar and Jaden. It was a very valuable training, and it kind of flew very nice from the theory side into the actual more practical when it comes to the VR training. So I definitely agree with my two mates, and I'm looking forward to more exciting new projects.
I think that they've said a lot of what I would say. I really enjoyed the experience. I think that it's cutting edge. It's definitely where training and education is going, and I look forward to seeing what the next edition will be like and hopefully experiencing that. Thank you.
And I just want to have a big thank you to Lucy Electric in general, just for obviously being part of this project and providing us a Lucy Trident at short notice and getting it to us here in Poland. Fantastic have you guys part of it, and collaborating with everybody there at Lucy has been a pleasure. I look forward to doing more projects with you in the future.
And likewise, Philip, Barry, and all of the team, it's been a real coup for us to have the real hardware here in the lunar landscape. We are dealing in a simulation mode with a lot of things that are implied or that are literally simulated in the analog. And to have the real hardware and to conduct training that's particularly relevant to a new settlement, as we are pitching ourselves in 2030 on the Lucy Electric, the Lucy station, it enables us to think through the types of settlement scenarios that will be very, very real, and the types of services and utilities that you support and provide on Earth are the kinds of infrastructures that we are going to increasingly require as we look at settling on other planetary surfaces. So we think this is an incredibly exciting addition to the analog stations that are situated around planet Earth. We hope that there is more involvement and opportunity for new space and defense contracts for you, or new engagement opportunities for you around the world as well. And as we explained yesterday, the crew were working in a dark lunar crater with cumbersome gloves, with cumbersome headgear, and it's very similar to the types of environments like the mining training environments and so on, or the desert landscapes that you are already working with big installations. And we got through it, and
well,
the crew were really excited about it, and having such a high fidelity opportunity in this situation was incredible. So thank you again. We look forward to sharing all of our results with you, and we look forward to meeting the new leadership team that have recently graduated and sharing our story. So thanks
again.
Thank you.